With Dragon Ball Super having to be rumored and returning later on this year in July of 2019, there have been many articles coming out debunking the very notion of Toei having to currently work on any Dragon Ball Super related episodes for the time being, courtesy of Newsweek.com. As you guys can see on screen, the update on Newsweek.com for Dragon Ball Super goes as follows. The update describes Toei Animation media representative David Sad denied the rumors. He told Newsweek that there are no new episodes of Dragon Ball Super being produced at this time. Now, the original story is a new report states that Dragon Ball Super Season 2 will return in July of this year. For months, there have been rumors and leaks of the anime starting Goku and Vegeta and the rest of the Z fighters returning, but it seems new information on production and timing was gathered by industry insiders. Now, there is no doubt that Dragon Ball Super will inevitably return, whether that be in July of 2019, October of 2019, or sometime in 2020, 2021. Toei Animation does not plan on stopping production for Dragon Ball Super in creating movies, in creating brand new episodes, figurines, merchandise, all of that stuff. But right now, it appears that one of Toei Animation's media representatives has come out in stating that at this current point in time right now, there are no new episodes planned for Dragon Ball Super. Now, you can take that with a grain of salt in the fact that either A, they're covering things up for a big announcement in the foreseeable future, or B, this could be true and Toei right now is simply not planning on doing any new Dragon Ball Super episodes, but instead something else. In my own subjective opinion, I do believe that Dragon Ball Super the anime is looming over the horizon, and I do believe that July 2019 is going to be the absolute best chance we have in having Dragon Ball Super return in the form of the anime later on this year. Even though right now we don't know the current staff, we don't know the overall time slot in which we're going to be seeing Dragon Ball Super in, the one thing that stands alone in comparison to what we've seen before in Dragon Ball Super is that this new anime is not going to start off with episode 1. This is going to be a direct continuation following the events of the Tournament of Power, having to include episode 132. There is no reason for Dragon Ball to reset and going back to episode 1. The title of Dragon Ball Super 2.0 is non-existent, which most likely when the show comes back is only going to be called Dragon Ball Super, and assumingly enough, the first episode of this returning anime is going to kick things off with episode 132. So keep your eyes and ears peeled for the month of April, as we are going to have definitive confirmation as to what's going to happen going forward. As once again, if you guys are new to this channel and love Dragon Ball and anime and want to stay in the loop in regards to news, information, and updates, then don't forget to go on ahead and smash that subscribe button and turn on all notifications to never miss a single upload. As with that being said, we have additional information in regards to Super Dragon Ball Heroes, the video game, in which directly ties into the ancient time patroller scene in the video game known as Shiratsu, as we do understand that in this upcoming video game for World Mission, Shiratsu is going to be the opposing figure in which our heroes are going to be forced and taking down, and it looks like he will in fact not only be a very menacing figure within Super Dragon Ball Heroes, but it also seems like he's going to have an additional transformation. Now, before all of that, as you guys can see on screen, we have another additional character in which we'll be going up against our heroes, and his name is Zamasu. Now, as you guys can see on screen, it looks like Zamasu is not only able to absorb and mimic the likes of Frieza and Cell within his body in taking that form, but also it looks like we will see a Hit slash Goku Black adaptation within Zamasu, as he is going to be able to shapeshift and possibly even absorb those characters into his own essence in manifesting himself, as you guys can see on screen, in not only being able to mimic one's power, but also techniques and abilities as well. So Shiratsu and Zamasu are going to be the main antagonists from what it seems like in Super Dragon Ball Heroes World Mission, which is very interesting considering who they are, where they come from, and what they have to offer in terms of being opposing figures against our current heroes, Goku, Vegeta, and the rest of the time patrollers and characters that we're going to be using to fight against them. So, the initial story behind Shiratsu is that he was a former time patroller working with Zeno, Goku, and company under the Kaioshin of Time. And after despairing over a timeline that he he wasn't able to save, he began to have thoughts about destroying the current history and creating a new world. So that's basically Shiratsu's MO in this game, is the idea that he was in fact a part of the Time Patrol working with Zeno Goku, but being that he wasn't able to save a specific timeline, he began to invoke his own sense of justice in taking that out on the current timeline. However, it's also implied that the reason why he decides to work with Amazu is because Amazu is actually a lifeless being with no emotion, that harbors no kind of intent, and that's exactly the type of person that Shiratsu wants to work with. Now, on top of all of this, we also have confirmation that Kid Goku from Dragon Ball GT will be included in Dragon Ball FighterZ, which is a pretty cool thing considering how far Dragon Ball FighterZ has come, and according to recent scans and spoilers for the Dragon Ball GT variation of Kid Goku, it looks like Goku is going to have two different level stages, including a possible hidden third. Now, with that being said, level 1 is listed as Super Kamehameha. When there are two or fewer characters remaining on your team, Goku does in fact go Super Saiyan 3, and of course level 2 is the Super Ultra Spirit Bomb, in which we've seen at the end of Dragon Ball GT. Of course, Ki Blast, Power Pulls, and Reverse Kamehamehas. There is also a rumor for another hidden third level. Now again, this may or may not be Super Saiyan 4. I'm fairly certain that if they do decide to include Super Saiyan 4 Goku, he is possibly going to be his own standalone character by using moves like the 10 times Kamehameha and the Super Dragon Fist. But right now for FighterZ, we do understand that both Gogeta and Broly are coming to FighterZ, but right now, what is in fact indefinite is Dragon Ball GT's variation of Kid Goku. And of course, some of his moves do include the Super Kamehameha on top of the Super Ultra Spirit Bomb. And no, just in case you're wondering, Super Saiyan 4 Goku has not been confirmed yet for Dragon Ball FighterZ, but inevitably, just like many other characters, we are going to be seeing that be adapted later on down the line. Now, in terms of Super Dragon Ball Heroes the anime, a lot of people were speculating and wondering what exactly happened to Goku after the events of him having to battle against Cumber on the prison planet. Well, a V-Junk Super Dragon Ball Heroes promo page suggests that Goku, and I quote, flew to the Grand Priest's palace at the last second during the collapse of the prison planet, with no further detail or information as to what exactly happened once he got there, other than him simply having to get a new uniform. That is it. So there's no implication that the Grand Priest trained Goku in any kind of way, so that in and of itself is in fact misinformation, especially if anyone is going around claiming that Goku did receive training in such a short amount of time. It is only implied that Goku flew to the Grand Priest's palace in the last second and simply got a new uniform on top of having his powers be restored. So there you guys have it, all the information you need for Dragon Ball FighterZ, Super Dragon Ball Heroes the video game, Super Dragon Ball Heroes the anime, and the future of the Dragon Ball Super anime. On top of everything else, guys, let me know your thoughts in the comment section below as to how you guys feel about the following information having to be presented. Thank you all so much for watching, guys. Once more, if you guys are new to the channel, don't forget to go ahead and smash that subscribe button, turn on all notifications, tune back in for the next video. For me, I'm very excited to see what's going to happen for Dragon Ball Heroes, for Dragon Ball Xenoverse. Of course, we have the brand new Dragon Ball RPG game coming out later on this year. We have the rumors of Dragon Ball Super. We have Super Dragon Ball Heroes. So much going on right now. So I hope you guys keep yourselves in the loop by punching that subscribe button. Slap a like down below if you guys are excited. Tune back in for the next video, and I'll be seeing each and every single one of you guys down in the comment section below. Have a great day, everybody. Peace!
This is the Galactic Emperor of the Universe, and of course I'm here to tell you to subscribe to UnrealEntGaming and all his social media platforms. Also, don't forget to turn on notifications so you can be the first to know every time that he uploads a new video.
Oh, did someone say UnrealEntGaming? Oh my god!
The fuck, Zarbon? Put on some clothes!
Well, why don't you put on any clothes?
What? I don't need clothes! Jesus Christ, that's huge!